Okay, so this is our next level up stretching, our intermediate stretching, I'm going to call it. This is for the stretches at the end of class. There was a standing up stretching sequence, which I've uploaded. This is now a sitting down one. It's a deeper stretch and it's more designed for dancers. And again, like our new intermediate warm-up, it's looking at hip flexors in particular and all the muscles you use as a dancer. Now, I'm also going to upload a much longer, probably half an hour at least, I would say, stretching sequence, which is going to be a really, really thorough stretch of all of the muscles. This sequence is, I believe it's 8 minutes, and we're only going to be able to do so much in that time, but we're going to do a cut down number, but we're going to really try and relax into it a bit in this sequence. And then if you want a deeper stretch, go and do the long one, which I'm going to record in a moment. So you're just going to be sitting down. You can either sit like this or with your legs crossed, or if that's uncomfortable for you, you can put your legs forward, just making sure you can see me. So I'm going to sit my legs crossed and we're going to swap them around halfway through. So let's go. We're just going to just sit and just relax, 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 relax a little bit. Just let everything go, spaghettify, spaghettify. Just bring your energy down and down and down and down and into the earth. And as we're sitting here, we're just going to start bringing our head side to side. Up and down. Make sure you're sitting up tall, still with your dancer's posture in your upper body. Good. And we're going to do head circles, very small ones, keeping at least a tennis ball size between our head and our neck at all times, just gently around one way. Shoulder. If you want, you can rest your hand on the head. If you want an extra stretch, you can bring your hand up like this and push this arm down. Okay, coming up, I'm going to turn this to a 45 degree, go down again. Now we're going to do the same the other side, so we're bringing our ear to our shoulder. We can rest our hand on our head if we want. If you want an extra stretch, bring your hand up like this and bring your head down to the floor. Back and doing the same. back, then you can either pull it up like this, or if you can't do that, you can bring your hands just like this. So stretching across your chest, shoulders should be down, not up. We're going to bring our feet together like this. We can stretch up and then fall forward. You should feel this in your lower back, your hips, your glutes. Alright, coming up, we're going to do a 90-90. This leg is at a 90 degree angle coming directly out, and this one's at a 90 degree angle in front. If you have a problem with your knees, you can just sit with your legs like this, but make sure you roll over so that you're feeling this hip joint. So this is opening this hip flexor. You may not be able to sit upright, but try and bring yourself upright and then just let this hip sink down. Just let it relax and open up. Just relaxing, letting go of your thighs, letting go of your glutes, just giving this hip flexor a chance to stretch. Just go with your body and don't do it. If anything hurts, come out of it. You can do the alternative I gave you. Alright. Going to keep this leg forward, but we're going to bring this back. Some call this pose in yoga the swan, and some call it the pigeon, depending on how posh you are. So this is stretching along your psoas muscle. Okay, then let yourself just fall forward here a moment. Coming up, this is my worst exercise. We're going to bring this foot up at the back here. This is stretching our thigh. Alright, and then as a nice reward for doing that hinky exercise, we're just going to bring this leg forward. We're going to come up and collapse over. Stretching your lower back, your glutes, this is a lovely stretch. If you only do one stretch a day, make it this one. Alright, coming up, we're going to do the same sequence on the other side. So 90-90, or the alternative I gave you. Just relax, relax, relax. Over into the swan. Grabbing your back foot, thigh stretch. Okay, this leg comes in front, we lift up and go over. So we're going to come up onto our feet, and if we can, we're just going to stretch out our calves. If you want to, you can go into, if you know the yoga pose, you can come here. Otherwise, you're just going to hold it here, however far you can get, but you want to feel it in your calves. And then we're going to come up into a headstand, just hold your elbows, you can just rock back and forth. You can shake your head no, nod your head yes. And then we're going to come, put our hands on our thighs, the lower back goes up to the ceiling like a cat stretch, up. This is stretching out that lower back. And then rolling up. And then we like to do three breaths. You can't really see me, but up and down. Up and down. Last one, up. And thank you very much.